Hi, dear viewers, and welcome back to Only Eunice. Today we're diving into the tech world, but not the one you may be familiar with. We're talking about China, a country that's been quietly building a tech empire. And let me tell you, they're not just following anymore. Until now, the US has been the unique, consistent tech innovator in the world for decades, but the landscape is shifting rapidly. China's tech scene is exploding, with companies innovating at a breakneck pace in AI, e-commerce, electric vehicles, you name it. I'm talking about companies you may not even know yet, but trust me, dear viewers, you'll hear from them soon. They're already changing the game, pushing the boundaries of what's possible, and challenging the pre-established tech order in the world. So buckle up, because in this series, we're going on a journey to explore the rise of Chinese tech, the innovations, the players, and what it means for the future of everything else. Artificial intelligence. It's the buzzword of the decade, but it's more than just a hype. It's the real deal, and it's going to reshape our world in a way we can't even imagine. Now, you've probably heard of Google's DeepMind or OpenAI, but what about DeepSeek? DeepSeek is a Chinese AI founded by a tech corporation named Baidu, which is basically China's equivalent of Google, and they've been making moves recently. We're talking next-level natural language processing, facial recognition that's straight out of a science fiction movie, and mainly globally superior algorithms in every single aspect. And China actually has a natural secret weapon. Here's their strategic advantage. Huge data. I mean, think about it. China has a population of over 1.4 billion people, generating an insane amount of data every single day. That's a goldmine for training AI models and giving Chinese companies a significant edge in machine learning over their competition. Now, here's how it works. So yeah, we've all heard of how much data is valuable, but in the world of AI, it's literally everything. The more data you have, the better you can train your algorithms, and China is swimming in it. This data advantage, combined with government backing and a strategy focused on becoming an AI superpower, has created the perfect storm for Chinese AI companies like DeepSeek to rise to the top. And they're not just catching up, they're innovating. DeepSeek, for example, recently achieved top-notch results for a major language model, surpassing even some of the American giants and at a fraction of their costs. If this isn't a clear sign that the AI playing field is leveling, then I don't know what is. So maybe it's time to realize that China isn't just playing around anymore, and that maybe they're here to win. All right, my friends, what about online shopping? You all know Amazon, right? Sure, Amazon is a monster in our part of the world, but in China, it's all about Alibaba. This e-commerce giant dominates the Chinese market with platforms like Taobao and Tmall that are practically woven into the fabric of daily life for a billion people. We're talking about a scale that's hard to comprehend, with Alibaba handling more transactions on a single day than some countries do in a year. With a very strong presence all across Southeast Asia, for over two decades, Alibaba is now relying on Temu to execute its international vision. So what's Temu? It is Alibaba's secret weapon, a cross-border e-commerce platform that's shaking things up. To make it short, Temu is a mobile app that offers a massive selection of goods at ridiculously low prices. That's basically what Temu is. So, how is Temu able to offer such crazy low prices? Well, they've cut out the middleman, connecting consumers directly with manufacturers, and they're leveraging China's manufacturing might to offer products at a fraction of the cost. But Temu isn't just about cheap prices, they're all about the shopping experience. Think flash sales, group deals, and a gamified shopping experience that keeps you coming back for more. It's a formula that's clearly working, with Temu rapidly gaining traction in markets around the globe. They're disrupting the established order and challenging the Amazons and Walmarts of the world, while showing the sheer scale and ambition of Chinese tech companies nowadays. So we've talked about AI, e-commerce, and now it's time to hit that automotive industry. I don't know if you've heard, but BYD's been conquering the world. BYD, which stands for Build Your Dreams, started out as a battery manufacturer. We're talking about vertical integration and making it happen. For example, their Blade battery is safer and more energy dense than Tesla's battery. They're also expanding into international markets faster than any other EV manufacturer and are becoming the number one electric car exporter in the world. In my opinion, it seems that the electric revolution is already here, and it's got quite a Chinese accent. So are these cars any good? That's a fair question to ask. BYD's not just competing on low prices. They're putting out sleek, tech-forward vehicles, sedan, SUV, even electric buses and trucks. They're also building a whole ecosystem, charging infrastructure, battery recycling plants, and so on. For these reasons, BYD is definitely a company to watch out for in the next few years, as they're poised to shake things up globally based on what they've accomplished so far. Now let's talk supercomputers. These aren't your everyday gaming rigs. They perform a quintillion calculations per second. For now, the US leads, but China is catching up fast. Machines like Sunway Taihu Lite and Tianhe 2A are top contenders. These supercomputers are already used in scientific research, climate modeling, and AI, and are showing astonishing results. Let's understand what they are. The race for exascale computing is heating up. Exascale means a billion calculations per second, more powerful than all the smartphones of the world combined. The US, China, Japan, and the EU are obviously competing. It's all about national pride and global dominance. Of course, the first one to succeed will gain a significant edge over the others, but building an exascale supercomputer is no easy feat. It requires breakthroughs in hardware, software, and cooling. Technologies like quantum computing are also used in the process, and the implications are massive. Huge breakthroughs in medicine, materials, science, and energy will be expected in the next few years. Now, as this new era of computing begins, China hopes to be at its forefront. Although I'm no big fan of this platform, we can't talk about China's tech scene without talking about TikTok. It's taken the world by storm with billions of downloads and countless hours of content. TikTok's powerful algorithm learns your preferences, offering you endless amount of stuff to watch. It's like having your own personal entertainment concierge in your pocket. Since its creation, TikTok has empowered a new generation of content creators, democratizing content creation for basically everyone. Some might dismiss TikTok as just dance crazes, but there's a little bit more to it. It could be used as a platform for education, activism, and business. Some scientists, artists, and entrepreneurs thrive there, as TikTok builds communities and fosters interaction, but it also faces a lot of controversy. We'll explore these issues in a later chapter. But first, let's talk about mobile payments in China. They've gone full-on cashless. Platforms like Alipay and WeChat Pay power this revolution. It's incredibly integrated and convenient. This technology reshapes their relationship with money in a way humanity has never witnessed before. Let's check out how. Now you might be thinking, Eunice, this is all cool and futuristic, but I'm not in China. And you're right, but here's the thing. China's fintech revolution is having ripple effects globally. Remember those clunky bank apps we used to have? They're slowly getting better, becoming more versatile, and offering more features. That's no coincidence. The success of Alipay and WeChat Pay has lit a fire under the global fintech industry. We're seeing a surge in mobile payment adoption, peer-to-peer payment apps are becoming mainstream, and even traditional financial institutions are stepping up their game. China has become a sort of testing ground for these technologies, and the rest of the world is watching and learning. And it's not just only about copying what China is doing, it's about understanding the underlying trends, the shift towards a more digital and connected economy, the demand for faster and more seamless transactions, and the increase of financial inclusion. China might be leading the charge right now, but the future of fintech is definitely global. China has made incredible advancements in AI, e-commerce, and electric vehicles. How did they get here so quickly? It's not just entrepreneurial spirit. The government played a significant role. Massive investments in R&D and initiatives like Made in China 2025 aim to transform China into a global manufacturing superpower, cultivating homegrown tech giants. This level of government involvement is unique. and it's yielded results. China has gone from a manufacturing hub to a hotbed of innovation, challenging Silicon Valley, but it's sparked debate. Some argue it stifles competition, while others see it as proof it works. It's a complex issue, and the world will be grappling with it for years to come. The Chinese government's role in its tech sector is a delicate balancing act. On one hand, you have the potential to accelerate innovation, provide crucial support to emerging industries, and shape the direction of technological development. On the other hand, there are legitimate concerns about the potential for overreach, the stifling of competition, and the implications for individual freedoms. It's a tightrope walk, and the Chinese government is constantly trying to find the right balance. The relationship between the Chinese government and its tech companies is also constantly evolving. Remember Jack Ma? He's the founder of Alibaba, Alipay, AliExpress, and Temu. Following criticism of Chinese regulators and the crackdown on his businesses, he has largely retreated from the public eye since 2020. This dynamic interplay between the state and the tech sector is fascinating to watch, and it's something that will continue to shape the future of technology, not just in China, but globally. We're all watching to see how this balance plays out and what it means for the future of innovation. China's tech rise is meteoric, but data privacy is a major concern. With vast data and surveillance, China's approach differs from the West because they have to comply with strict government ruling. This creates unique challenges and ethical dilemmas for businesses and their owners. Imagine tech companies having to balance government demands with global expectations while innovating at the same time. That's just wild. Beyond data privacy, there are also concerns about censorship and intellectual property theft. China's internet is heavily censored, blocking many websites and services. This has drawn criticism and sparked debate about internet freedom. Intellectual property theft is another major issue. Accusations against Chinese companies have fueled trade tensions. These issues are complex and nuanced, so we shouldn't expect mainstream media to brighten the image for us, but we must seek for ourselves. Various political interests and perspectives are at play in this game, so understanding these challenges is crucial for the future of our beloved planet. China's rise in AI, e-commerce, and EVs is reshaping global tech. What does this mean for the future of tech? For decades, Silicon Valley has led, but China's challenging that leadership. And it's time to forge a new path. Therefore, ignoring China is no longer an option, as it could lead us to a multipolar tech world. And we really don't want that. Let's check out why. Now, this whole shift obviously has huge implications. On the one hand, more players, especially those as ambitious and well-resourced as China, could mean faster progress overall. Competition often breeds innovation, right? But it's not all sunshine and rainbows. This kind of tech race could also lead to more friction, more trade disputes, and even slow down the sharing of knowledge that's been so crucial to tech's advancement. Remember, a lot of the technologies we use today were a result of human beings sharing information. Now, how can we sustain this model on the long term while facing these issues? And of course, there's the whole question of ethics. How do we ensure that things like AI are developed with respect for human rights and ethics, regardless of who is building it? These are questions that, frankly, nobody has all the answers to yet. One thing's for sure, the tech landscape is changing, and China will be a major driving force behind that change, with all that involves. All right, so we know a lot more about China's tech scene in general, but let's get specific. And there's no better place to start than with Huawei. This company is like the poster child for China's tech ambitions, but also for the controversies that come with it. They're building a massive amount of the world's 5G infrastructure right now, illustrating Huawei's incredible growth from a telecom equipment company to a global giant. I mean, we're talking about the backbone of the internet here, and they were positioned to be the dominant player. But their success didn't come without a cost. They've been caught in the crosshairs of the US-China trade war, facing accusations of espionage and intellectual property theft. which they repeatedly denied. This led to sanctions that seriously hampered their smartphone business, especially their access to Google's apps and services. What's fascinating about Huawei is that despite these setbacks, they haven't stopped growing. Now let's shift gears from the world of smartphones and networks to something that's quite literally taken flight, talking about drones. And when it comes to drones, there's one name that's synonymous with the technology. It's DJI. Seriously, DJI has a level of dominance in the drone market that's almost unheard of. We're talking about a market share that's consistently been around 75%, which is insane. From hobbyist flyers to professional filmmakers, chances are, if you've seen a drone in action, it was most likely a DJI. But their success isn't just about making cool gadgets. They've consistently pushed the boundaries of what drones can do, from incredible image stabilization to obstacle avoidance systems that seem like they're straight out of a sci-fi movie. And it's not just about capturing stunning footage. DJI's drones are being used in all sorts of industries. Agriculture, construction, search and rescue, you name it. They've even played a huge role in disaster relief efforts, providing critical assistance in situations where it is too dangerous for humans to go. So, we've covered a ton of ground here. From the rise of AI to the dominance of e-commerce giants and the race for technological supremacy, one thing's clear. China's tech scene is no longer an afterthought. They're major players, pushing the boundaries of innovation and reshaping the global tech landscape. Whether it's Huawei's battle for 5G dominance, DJI's grip on the drone market, or the countless other companies making waves, China's impact is undeniable. And this is just the beginning. So what do you guys think about China's rise in tech? Is it a threat or a simple evolution of history? Drop your comments below. As always, thanks for watching. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to OnlyUNES for more inspiring documentaries.